Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, the insertion, and the action of the iliotibial tract.
Here you can see the iliotibial tract highlighted in green, and you can see how it's located in the lateral thigh, it's crossing both the hip joint, and it's crossing the knee joint as well. Let's swap to a different view so we can take a better look. Here we can see the iliotibial tract from a lateral view. The iliotibial tract is sometimes referred to as the iliotibial band, or ITB for short. Very rarely, it might also be referred to as Messier's band. That's after the French anatomist who discovered it. Now, the iliotibial tract isn't classed as a muscle. Rather, it's a thick band of connective tissue known as fascia. However, the iliotibial tract is actually connected onto the tensor fascia lata muscle, which you can see right here, and it's also connected onto the gluteus maximus muscle as well. And you can see how the fibers of the gluteus maximus and the tensor fascia lata muscle are merging into the fascia of the iliotibial band through an aponeurosis. And that means when these two muscles contract, they can influence the iliotibial tract. And we'll go over what that means when we go over the functions of the iliotibial tract a little bit later in this video. If you'd like to learn more about the gluteus maximus or the tensor fascia lata, I'll put links in the description box below to their videos so you can click on them afterwards and view their videos as well. So let's take a look at the origin next. You can see that marked out here in red, and that's going to be on the iliac crest. And the iliac crest is just the ridge along the top of the hip bone here. And specifically, if we want to describe the part that it's on the lateral aspect of the iliac crest. In addition to the iliac crest, the iliotibial band also connects to the gluteus maximus muscle and the tensor fascia lata muscle via an aponeurosis, and this connection can be classed as an origin point as well. Moving on to the insertion next, you can see I've got that marked out in blue either side on the lateral condyle of the tibia. And this insertion is going to be on the tubercle of the iliotibial tract. This is also known as Gerdy's tubercle, and that's going to be a round nodule or a small bony bump that's just located in that area I've got marked out in blue.
So let's take a look at the actions next. Now, the iliotibial tract is going to be coming down where I've got this red band here, connecting the hip to the tibia. Now, you'll remember earlier in the video how I mentioned how the iliotibial tract isn't a muscle. So because it's not a muscle, it's not going to be contracting, it's connective tissue. And the TFL and the gluteus maximus, they're both going to be connecting into the iliotibial tract. So as they contract, as the gluteus maximus and the TFL contract, it's going to pull on the iliotibial tract and create tension. And that tension is going to provide stability to the hip joint, and it's also going to provide stability to the knee joint as well. So the primary action of the iliotibial tract is to provide stability to the hip and stability to the knee. That's going to be lateral stability because it's coming down the lateral side of that joint, or both those joints, should I say. Secondarily, it's also going to support the gluteus maximus and the TFL in their actions as well, because it's creating that attachment point for both those muscles. So it's essentially giving them something to connect onto and connect all the way down to the tibia as well. So it's going to support both of them in their actions. As for the gluteus maximus, its primary actions are going to be hip abduction, so pulling the leg out to the side like that, and also hip extension. So we got the hip flexed right now, extension would be moving the leg backwards. As for the TFL, its primary action is going to be hip abduction. Now, both those muscles have other actions as well. If you want to learn more about them in more detail, check out the description box below, because I've got links to both their videos as well. If you've enjoyed this video or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like, subscribe, let me know what you thought of the video in a comment. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. I'll see you all next time.